Warning, this video features one or more ships that are primarily acquired through gambling mechanics. The chance of winning such ships is very low, and there's no guarantee that you will win regardless of how many times you gamble. If you think you might have a problem with gambling addiction, please stop the video and seek help immediately. Greetings everyone and welcome to another Starship review. Today we're going to take a look at the Jovian Heavy Raider, which was just added to the Infinity Lockbox. It's one of the few ships in the game to have both Miracle Worker and Intel seating, making it very potent for energy weapon builds. I talk about how the ship is relevant to the TV show, but I haven't been watching Discovery, so all I really know is that it's from the 32nd century. Either way, it has a cool transformation animation, but we'll look at that when we get to the console. Let's have a look at the ship itself first. As a 5-1-1 Raider with 5 tactical console slots and good maneuverability stats, it's well suited to DPS. The aforementioned Miracle Worker and Intel seating are great for energy weapon builds. The Jovian is a full Intel ship, but since the full Intel goodies aren't very, what's the word I'm looking for? Good, it hardly makes a big difference. However, and this is a big however, future Gauss talking here with a script revision, by the way, they just made a change to the game so that you can solo queue DPS maps like ISA and ISE. Intel team is going to be a vital and powerful part of the build strategy for those solo queues, since it gives you targeting stealth. It pairs well with Exodus Acta Probat, which gives you even more stealth. If you're a KDF player, you might still be able to get it for a somewhat reasonable price off the exchange, otherwise you'll have to buy it from a lockbox ship in order to get it. Another victim of cross-faction flying. None of that is what this video is about, but since it's fresh news, I thought I'd include it as it increases the value of this ship and other ships that have Intel seating a little bit. The Bridge Officer seating has the Miracle Worker on a Lieutenant seat, which isn't ideal, but since Raiders have mostly universal seating, you should be able to do what you need with your BOF powers. Like most dual-spec ships, where both specs have powers you want, it's going to be cramped, but as I've said before, it's a happy problem. Kinetics are much better than energy weapons at the moment, so if all you care about is DPS, then the lack of a command seat probably puts it behind even something like the Tamir, which is a Raider we got for free not too long ago. However, the Jovian has something the Tamir does not, a very awesome console. It's not as awesome as it should be, because the flight speed and turn rate passives are only active when out of combat, but it's still pretty cool nonetheless. Harvester mode generates stacks of harvest from up to 2 targets every half second up to 30 stacks. In practice, it's pretty easy to get the maximum number of stacks as long as you have it near a couple of enemies when you use it. 30 stacks will net you 60 skill points to most skills, which are probably the same ones Inspirational Leader effects, though I have no confirmation of that. If you remember the spreadsheet I used in the skill tree video, then you know that 60 skill points across the board is a pretty decent buff. In addition, you get Beam Overload and Cannon Rapid Fire up to rank 3, depending on how many stacks of harvest you acquired. These are pretty decent buffs, but they only last for 15 seconds out of every 2 minutes, and the only passive that really applies in combat is Control Expertise. It's not a bad console by any means, but I think I'd only use it specifically with this ship in order to get the transformation animation. The trait, Precision Scrapper, is also pretty interesting. When damaging foes with Surgical Strikes, Beam Overload, or Tractor Beam of all things, it gives out Kobayashi Maru-style buffs to nearby allies. These buffs are very good, essentially comprising almost everything you'd want, like Cat 2 damage, Hull and Shield Cap, damage resistance, and flight speed. The trait can trigger once every 2 seconds, making it very easy to get all the buffs. This is an excellent trait, and frankly, it's making me consider picking up the ship, although I probably won't. Even if the only person to get these buffs were yourself, it's still a very impressive list, and the fact that it buffs your teammates as well is just sugar on top. It's the first team buffing trait I can think of that really feels powerful. The new experimental weapon, the Threat Deterrent Charge Launcher, is the first of its kind as it offers passive buffs. In this case, that buff is 50% threat reduction. The weapon itself does electrical damage and has a chance to placate, which grows with each hit until the target is placated, upon which it resets to its default chance. The placate is probably more useful than the threat reduction, but it's definitely a tool for the toolkit. So while I have no short-term or obvious use for it, I'm glad they added it to the game, and I would encourage them to keep doing more stuff like this. Variety is the spice of life. Okay, score time. In terms of performance, it gets 5 stars. Strong DPS stats and Miracle Worker seating make it a very powerful ship. The Intel seating gives it some versatility for solo queues. Most raiders don't have 5 4-weapon slots, so this is automatically one of the better raiders. This is a very powerful ship that feels a bit overshadowed by the legendary D7, but has the same primary and secondary specialization seats, lore appeal, and can be had in the C-Store as an account unlock. In terms of accessories, I'm going to give it an enthusiastic 4 stars. There's a lot to like here, but that doesn't mean it's top-shelf stuff. I really appreciate them doing something different with the experimental weapon, and it will probably find a home somewhere, but it's unlikely to get people off the Soliton Wave Impaler. The console is a lot of fun, but I wouldn't use it on any other ship but this one. The trade is the best of the bunch, and while you could absolutely use it riding solo and feel good about it, group content is where it really shines. I'm excited about it, but in an MMO with a very strong single-player vibe, and where most of the group content is easily bested by the player base, I'm not sure how much wider appeal it's going to have for most people when it's just a simple stat booster. There are only a couple of kinds of people who are going to be interested in this one. Number chasers like myself who want the trait for support builds, and collectors who want the fun, shiny console animation. As a practical matter, you're almost certainly better off waiting for another sale on the D7, assuming you didn't get it already, if the seating is what you're attracted to. This is just another expensive premium ship to lump on the already very large pile of expensive premium ships. And that's it. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, please like and subscribe so you can see more of my content in the future. As always, take care, and I'll see you in the next one. Waiting for the airplane to go by, yeah, yeah, yeah. Waiting for a truck to go by. Waiting, waiting for a truck to go by. Keep moving, Mr. Truck, keep going. Keep on trucking, keep on going down the road. Seven that has the same primary and secondary specialization seats.